Yo, what's up? It's your boy Cool B. You know how we do it. Them Boys TV, always on the scene. Look who I got on the show today, baby. Mr. Shock G, Digital Underground. What's up with you, baby?
I'm shocking them when I'm G'ing them and I get paid for keeping the women screaming. Ha ha.
What's up, man?
What it do?
So, how you feeling that KC crowd, man? They was loving you, baby.
Man, that felt like church right there, man. That was a good one. Yo, first, Humpty came out and had his time with him.
Yeah.
And that was fun, and they was doing the Humpty too. They was doing a dance with us. And then Shock G dropped some Looney stuff and some Kiss You Back and whatnot, and they was messing with us too. But the most beautiful thing of the night for me personally was when the piano man came out and we touched them keys and Pee-wee came out on the guitar. And DJ Fuse came out and we got live on their ass and it went lovely. It went nice, man. Hey, you know what though? All jokes aside, KC got a lot of love for hip hop, man.
A lot of love.
Yeah. I felt it.
Yeah, we had Biz Markie swing through about a week and a half
the
ago,
Biz,
man.
The Biz.
Man, they show much love, man. It's a hip hop legends tour. You know what I'm saying? They show much love, man. It's a lot of hip hop fans.
That what y'all hear in the background right now? That's Tretch, Vin Rock, K Diesel, Naughty by Nature on stage, and after them, Rick the Ruler with Dougie Fresh.
That's what's up. It's crazy in here tonight.
It's crazy.
So, man, for my people that don't know where Shock G from, man, let's talk a little bit about shit. Where you from, baby?
Shit, I'm mainly from the same place you from, We all from this Little Rock, flying around the sun. But I was born in Brooklyn. When I was 6 years old, my family moved upstate New York. When I was about 8 years old, my dad got a job down in Tampa, moved the whole family to Florida. I lived in Tampa till I was about in junior high school. Family got divorced, moms pulled me to Queens, New York. Went to junior high in Queens, and then went to high school back in Tampa because my dad got custody. So I'm not a military baby, but I might as well have been because my family didn't know who wanted to raise who or what, and we were just all over the place. And I love them for that. I'm not clowning my mom and my dad. I'm glad that they had love and then moved on and added more people to the family because it looked like United Nations at a Jacobs or a Racker family Thanksgiving. We got the Hindus, the Indians, the Africans, the Jamaicans, the blacks, the whites, candy stripes. And that's why I wound up trying to do the music that way. You know, red, white, tan, black, yellow, or brown. Really doesn't matter. We can all get down. And from now on, I'm neither black nor white. I'm OB. That's Obama Brown.
That's what's up, man. That's what's up. Family is definitely important.
Yeah. And I left out the tail end of the story. After I got out of college, I did study a little music theory and blah, blah, blah. I did some traveling, backpacking around the United States. I wound up in Oakland. Me and my girl, we just eloped to California. Wound up working in a music store in Oakland. And it was there in the late 80s when I met all the people who became Digital Underground. And Digital Underground happened out of Oakland. So we really are an Oakland group. Even though now I live in L.A., Pee-wee live in Sacramento. You know, Sean living in New York. Money B living Rialto, DJ Fuse still live in Oakland. We all over the United States now. But DU is an Oakland band. Yeah. Tupac was so deep that I didn't spend too much time staring at that man and listening, biting his lyrics and messing with him because he was just my dog, you know what I mean? And when you got greatness around you, the only thing you can do to keep from being like, oh my God, every day and illing him out, bugging him out, I just had to just like hold it in and be like, that's Pop, that's my man. And just when he was like, yo, let's go to the studio, nigga. I went in the studio. You know what I mean? I'm glad he called me in the studio as many times as he did. And a few times I'll call him, I was like, Pop, can you come through the studio? And as you see, a few times he came through for us too. So it's just like, now in hindsight, of course, it's Tupac the God. Tupac the genius, Tupac the icon, Tupac the humanitarian hero. But when he was around us, I didn't really look at him that way. He was just my little crazy cousin, you know, who's always into something, always cursing out the police, always getting into some funk, and always having all the hot females around him. So to me, Pac was just hip hop.
Right,
he was just hip hop, you know.
That's what's up, man. Yeah. That's really what's up, man. So, hey,
Tours were fun. It wasn't tense. Now it's like, we got beef with them. We can't go to the after party with them. Might be a shootout. Man, when me and these cats was on tour, Dougie Fresh and Naughty by Nature and Tupac and the early Tupac when he was with Digital Underground and doing his first solo stuff, Public Enemy, Heavy D and the Boys, Big Daddy Kane, Queen Latifah, we used to have so much fun. It was ridiculous. Everybody rode on anybody's bus. We all going to the same city. It didn't matter what bus you got on. And it didn't matter who road manager was standing there, that was your road manager. It didn't matter who bodyguard was standing there, that was your bodyguard. We were all family. All the groups on tour, everybody, all the groups in hip hop, really, it was like a code of honor. What I want to say about that the most is hip hop used to only be mad at the establishment, mad at the system, mad at the powers that be, the government, the police, not each other. Now we mad at each other. So what's considered the most hip hop now is the least hip hop to me. What they say is real hip-hop, you ain't real unless you thugging. That ain't hip-hop. Oh, you got skills with a gun? You good with a gat? Go join the military or police force or something. When you got skills with that art, that's when you belong in this game. And if you're a poet, you belong in this game. If you happen to be a gangster and you're a poet too, that's cool, but you can't just be a gangster and think that qualifies you as hip-hop. I'm hip-hop because I went to the pen. It's about staying out the pen.
That's real, it is. Man. That's what's up, man. That's some knowledge that we like to, you know, for the artists to show, man. Give some of our young brothers to let them know what's really going on.
Hey, but it ain't like Shock Gear spoke. It's that I got lucky, and when I was a young gun-toting fool, I didn't get caught up. I got lucky. I had my days of thinking that was how what you got to do. Everybody got to find their manhood, and some of us act wild when we're young, and that's just a rite of passage. So I'm not knocking nobody for that. I'm just saying, you know, it's okay to smile and be friendly and make songs about good things and being good in life. It's okay to do that too. You ain't gotta be Talib Kweli, you could be anybody.
That's right.
And
real.
Speak that good game,
that's
you know?
Real, man. That's real.
Yeah.
So for the people, man, that, you know, that wanna read up on Shock G, you know, get the little, something, you know, you got a MySpace page, you know, I mean, how can they find you, man?
It's easy, you just Google Shock G. Yeah. And then you can find the MySpace, the Wikipedia, all the YouTubes, whatever we've been doing. Just look for it. Just put Shock G in there and you'll find it. If you want to see something with me and Pac back in the day, Google them two names together. You want to see some old Humpty acting up, Google Digital Underground. But we online, we out there heavy, and we still in the record stores too. And people talking about, why y'all ain't making records? We making records. Why y'all ain't getting them no more?
Hey, we gotta make sure y'all holler at my man Shock G, man. Hey, this your man Cool B. Your man Shock
Cool
G
B, love you,
on
baby.
Them boys TV, man.
Last
Thanks
thing
a lot
I wanna say, last thing I say is K Zero. Whoa. Peace to Tech 9.
That's what's up, man. Hey,